Oh, nhớ to má mẹ.
Siskiyou County is divided.
9 o'clock. We're going to go ahead and start. I know that there are more people coming.
On one side are the Hmong, immigrants from Southeast Asia. On the other side are local leaders who are meeting to vote on laws that target the Hmong and their livelihoods.
Would you pray with me this morning? Heavenly Father, we come to you today asking for your guidance and support on behalf of our Board of Supervisors as they begin their meeting. In your son's name we ask these things. Amen. Water!
The conflict here boils down to water and who gets to use it during California's drought.
Water!
Over the last 6 years, about 4,000 Hmong people moved to Siskiyou, and a number of them bought up land for farms. Just not the kind of farms the locals like.
These people are here illegally growing their pot. They come up here and invade our county on an annual basis, and they don't care what they do to our property, and they have destroyed it.
The county passed two ordinances that restrict how people here can sell and transport water, but only in certain areas. County leaders claim they're just focusing on places with illegal marijuana, but the Hmong say the laws target their neighborhood.
The county just quietly, procedurally voted to restrict the water for all these people, and they're outside demanding water. It's really striking the mood in that room, so subdued, and the mood out here is anger is palpable.
All parents, all grandparents fought so hard to get us here.
Raise your hand if your family had passed away because your family protected the U.S. military.
Most Hmong Americans are first and second generation refugees who resettled after years of being persecuted, after fighting for the U.S. during the Vietnam War.
We have been described as cartel, Asian mafia. We only make 2% of Siskiyou. And why are they targeting us?
Even though California has legalized marijuana, the county still bans commercial cultivation. The sheriff's office raids about 150 illegal grows each year. And lately, they've been visiting this neighborhood almost every week.
And this over here is the Shasta Vista, which is where we're headed today.
The sheriff's office says Mount Shasta Vista is home to more than 5,000 greenhouses full of illegal plants.
So these are sentries or lookouts. They have a huge phone tree, so they'll notify one another that the sheriff's office is on its way.
Let's go. Sheriff's office, show yourself. Search warrant.
Sheriff's office, search warrant.
I'm through.
The sheriff's office just cleared this property, going around like a tactical team with their long guns out. Looks like nobody's here. You can see here we got a bunch of pot plants in the side of this greenhouse.
I don't have my knife. I left it.
Siskiyou County has been home to illegal marijuana cultivation for years. But the Hmong say authorities are using water as an excuse to single them out.
If everybody's growing out here, why only enforce the water law for this community?
Because this is the biggest slice of the pie. They are the most dominant growers in the county.
The cops claim it's not just about the pot. There's also pollution and water being wasted during a drought.
Yeah, you can see the chemicals all up here at the pool.
How standard is this for agricultural purposes, and how much of it is toxic hazardous?
I couldn't tell you. All this stuff just stays here. So you have all your wildlife, or you know, this things get cracked because it freezes, and then it just leaches out through the environment.
There's a lot of whatever it is.
There it is.
So the sheriff's found, they call it a spider hole, basically a secret pit that was covered with sand. And whoever was here buried a bunch of garbage bags full of marijuana trimmings and an actual weed for safekeeping until they could, I guess, find somebody to buy it.
1.32.
They weigh close to a pound, right around in the neighborhood of a pound.
That's a whole lot of weed. Each one's a bag of money that's about to go get ground into dust.
In just a few hours, the deputies destroyed thousands of plants and several hundred pounds of marijuana, but made no arrests.
You ever feel like, why bother? What are we doing?
Right. Well, yeah, I mean, you got people saying just legalize it, you know, and tax it. How can you tax this? We're not dealing with honest folks here. If you have nothing to hide, then why are you running?
They're farmers. Hmong people, that's all they know how to do, especially our elders.
There aren't many wells in Shasta Vista, so most water is trucked in. The county has tried to ban the trucks in certain areas, leaving the Hmong without water for crops or other needs.
The whole Asian community here in Siskiyou uses about 300,000 gallons per day. But one farmer out here uses over 1 million. Think about all these farmers around here. And they're blaming that the Asian community are the one that are creating the drought for this county.
The Hmong say the county's water truck ban hampered their efforts to fight a wildfire back in June.
Sometimes I don't even recognize it. I have to use GPS, otherwise I can't get around here. A lot of people lost money, a lot of people lost their pet, they lost their home, livestock, everything.
During the evacuation, police opened fire on a 35-year-old Hmong man. Community members say he was fleeing the fire with his family. Four officers reportedly fired dozens of rounds into the man's truck, killing him in front of his wife and children, who were behind him in a separate vehicle. Police say the man was armed.
And the allegation is that the sheriff stopped him and that he then refused to evacuate and drew a gun. And fired a shot
right
at the sheriffs.
Right.
Why do you think that didn't happen?
Because I'm a father myself. If I'm already evacuating my family out of danger zone to take them into a safety area, why would I bring them back into harm's way?
You don't think it's possible that he ran into a bunch of cops, panicked, got scared, pulls out a gun?
Oh, fuck no. If I were to take my kids, my family out, I have a clear mind of what exactly I need to go do. I'm scared already. I would not pull out a gun.
The Siskiyou County District Attorney says the county's investigation remains ongoing. The Hmong community has called for the state to take up the case. On top of everything, the Hmong are still fighting for water. And for that, they need Steve Prissett.
So this is a 350 horse motor. It can pump about 3,000 gallons a minute. Our pumps will pump out about 6 million gallons a day onto our alfalfa fields.
Grissett has a deep well on his property that makes him the man that Hmong farmers pay to fill up their trucks.
6 million gallons a day that you pump in your fields, how much would you sell to the Hmong on a busy day?
350,000 gallons.
It feels like a drop in the bucket.
It is. We filled these trucks from 2016, 17, 18, 19, and then all of a sudden overnight, it's illegal.
The sheriff's office has pressured local businesses to stop delivering supplies like soil and fuel to marijuana growers. And the county has also outlawed selling water used for illegal cultivation. When Grissett refused to comply, they sued him.
I've never heard in this country of using that as a tactic, as a political and a police action to just outright deny people water. It's like barbaric.
Hmong water trucks have been sitting idle near Grissett's farm while the water laws are challenged in court.
I just wish they could.
The man enforcing those laws is Sheriff Jeremiah LaRue, and he's not backing down.
It's like a third world country out there, and that cannot be okay. Forget about cannabis. It's just about quality of life and how people are living out there.
What is your message to the Hmong community today going forward?
It's going to really take a concerted effort from the people in the Hmong community or in the Asian community to recognize that this isn't a battle of race or a war that we have that's going to continue in the future. It needs to just be about really the compliance with the laws.
I mean, there's certainly a perception that this sheriff's department is targeting the Asian American community and particularly the Hmong community.
All I can offer is my opinion, which hopefully is taken as truth. We have to focus where we can make the greatest impact. And if it happens to be that people are Asian that are growing marijuana, so be it.
When did it start to change and become what you feel is a racist atmosphere?
As soon as LaRue took office, he goes, okay, let's go ahead and cut out the water. That's exactly what happened. They cut off the water to just the Asian community. They're saying that this is not about race, but it is about race.
In a statement to Vice News, the county district attorney said their goal is to curb illegal marijuana cultivation and the threat it poses to the public. He called the allegations of racism, quote, simply a self-serving statement by an interested group. But earlier this month, a federal judge temporarily blocked the water truck ban, saying it had the effect of cutting off the water supply to a minority community that has recently been the target of racial prejudice.
It's been a while. We only have three trucks. Normally there'd be a lot. So the county accomplished their goal. They ran these people out of here.
The county is fighting the decision. But while the case plays out in court, water trucks have trickled back onto Grissette's farm to fill up, but not as many as before.
Thank you for the water. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, very happy today.
Yeah, me too.